Alright, welcome back. In the previous video, we were able to extract the preparation methods from the website. So we extracted static number of steps. That means the four steps we have extracted. But actual scenario, this will not be the case. It might have more than four steps or even less than the four steps. In such cases, our robot execution will be failed. So we need to handle it with the dynamic selector. Let us move back to UiPath Studio and let us see how to manage this. So what I have done, I just deleted all the steps except retaining the step 1. So if you see my previous video, I explained all the selector values will be remain same except this IDX property. So this value keep on changing 1, 2, 3, 4 like that based on the steps. Okay, so we need to play around this value. We need to make it dynamic so that it could extract the appropriate steps from the UI element. Perfect. So for that, what we'll do is first we need to use the UI Explorer for the dynamic selectors, indicate element, and assign. Just press F2 to pass the selection for 3 seconds. And then spy out the step 1. I am extracted the step 1. Okay, I just copy this one. Okay, as you seen here, IDX value is 1. And what I will do here, I will assign a variable because it should be dynamic and it should be placed always into the activity of get full text. So, open advanced editor. Just paste it over here, just make it a single line. Okay, now it's in single line. Okay, now we have to create a counter for this dynamic value. Okay, for that again create one more variable over here, counter. I think I have created, let us see. Okay, counter is there. I have created a counter variable and scope is search activity and initial value is 1. Okay, so I have already created, let us see. And then what I will do in the selector, instead of hard coding this value, I mean IDX value, I'll put actual counter counter dot toString. I'll place it and quote, close the quote and enter the less mark. Done. We are done with the placing dynamic counter value onto this selector. Okay, now this is assigned to selector variable, so we will replace the static selector to dynamic selector over here. This is the second step. I am going to do that. Okay, done. Assigned it. Now we need to increase the counter value, so again assign one more variable after this get full text activity, assigned to here again counter equals to counter plus one. So this will work for the single sequence. I mean it will execute it within exit from the scope. To make it work as a loop, we have to place the do while. So just place the do while loop above here and drag and drop this get full text activity into the body and also assign variable into this one. Okay, we are assigning the variable. Now what we have to do, we need to update the selector with the counter, right? So I'll just copy this one, I'll paste it here. Okay, so now this is again counter.true. After updating also, it's updating here, right? Okay, so this is selector. Okay, it's updating the selector. Next, let's assume like it's executed 4 steps, and after the 4 step it should check for the 5th step is available or not. So we have to use the element exist for that. I'll just drag and drop element exist. So what we will check it, we'll check with the selector. So this selector with the updated counter value exists in the UI element, or it matches with the UI element. So you just go here, select this one, exist element properties. You just here selector to selector, you just place that one. Okay, done. So it will check for selector is there or not. If it is there, then it should go back to the loop, else it should exit. And then we have to place is next step exist variable. Okay, if that will check over in the condition. If next step exists, it will move back, otherwise it will exit. Okay, now what we have done, we are assigning the dynamic variable to selector, and it comes here, it will extract the text value. Go back here and see here step one, it will extract the step content, and it will put the content into the output variable step one. Next we have to concatenate all the steps values, right? For that, what we will do is we will assign one more variable. I'll place assign activity here. I'll just put final val. This is the variable I created, equals to final val. It's just nothing but concatenation. Final value plus what is that? BBLF for new line. Okay, plus step one. Okay, now final value is coming here, and it will increment the counter. It will check for whether selector exists or not. If that particular selector exists, it will move, it will go back to the loop, else it will exit from the scope. Fine. Now what we can do is, after this do while loop, we'll place a message box, right, to check that. So where is message box here? You can just drag and drop this message box after the do while loop. So here you just place final value, so it will show the final value extracted. Okay, so these are the five steps I included. Let us try with our website. Let me move back to landing page. Once it move back to landing page, we'll run the process or robot. Okay, done. It's moved in landing page, it's appeared or loaded properly. So I'll run the file. Okay, so once exit started, it will start from the adding keyword. So it is taking a while due to the internet connectivity. So let us wait for a while. Okay, it started searching banana recipe, and it will take one of the recipe because we have given the range as 1 instead of 100. Okay, so it should take it up one of the recipe, and it will start extracting the content ingredient first, and later it will extract the steps for preparation or methods. Okay, for the continuity, please watch my previous video as well. So you will be able to understand the scope of this demo, etc. I have made all the videos maximum 5 minutes because the short videos will have more interesting and easy to learn as per my experience. Okay, it's navigate to the detail screen of recipe. Now we should extract the ingredients. Okay, it's extract the ingredients, fine. Now we should extract the preparation methods. Let us see. Extract that data within few seconds. Perfect. So it's extracted all the four steps. Even though we use single activity to extract the content or preparation methods, it's extracted all the four steps dynamically. That's how we can use dynamic selector in such scenarios. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.